Welcome back, everyone. Toybiz here, and I am back yet again to give you guys a Retroshiz look back at the past. In a way, it's not action figure related, but it is Spider-Man the Animated Series related, and you know how much I love talking about that. This is something I found in the thrift store about last year. It was just sitting on a shelf. It was a thrift store where all the books are in the front. This was on the front of the stack of them, and I picked it up. $1.59 at Kmart back in the day. The back has all the gorgeous artwork from the show, stuff that you really didn't see back in the day, and it's also on the new retro packaging as well for some of those Marvel Legends. So, got my Spider-Man figure. This is going to be fun. Sit back, relax, grab yourself a nice hot cup of coffee. This is a look at the big coloring book, golden book, Spider-Man, the Animated Series. Let's just open it right up right now, and already we got some insane coloring going on. Bare minimum work, I will say. Look at that, 1995 golden book, all that good stuff. I mean, you could have at least colored a little bit more of him. Oh my God, here we go. Peter Parker was a high school science student, which in the animated series, he was a college student, but he's still wearing the same clothes, apparently. All right. One day, Peter was bitten by a radioactive spider. He looks shocked, and we all know that he ran outside, almost got hit by a car, had a bad dream. You know, that's how the animated series did his origin. But yeah, this is kind of it. Peter gained the powers of a spider. He jumped up on the wall to avoid the car and then realized, yeah, he's got some spider powers going on. Again, I don't know what's up with the purple hair on Peter Parker. That's not screen accurate. As Spider-Man, Peter Parker could do amazing things. At least on this, they got the colors right. Overall, that's pretty good. That's pretty solid. He could have colored in the red spider symbol, but you know what? I'm not here to judge you. Spider-Man doing his jumping flip thing. I don't know. Maybe it's a neogenic nightmare. You know, he's in pain. He's got a couple extra arms about to grow or something. And then you got Peter Parker, Spider-Man throwing some webs. Again, not too shabby of coloring. Could stay the lines a little bit more. And then I think the kid gave up because there's only a few more pages that are colored. But nice line art of Spider-Man zipping over the city. And this is actually pretty cool. This is from the box art for the parachute Spider-Man from one of the Spider-Man waves as well. So that's cool. You know, I just love the reuse of that. That's not too bad. Now we're getting into the villains. Shocker is a super villain. His vibro shock units send out powerful vibrations that can crumble concrete. Yes, that is true. We did see that many times in Spider-Man the Animated Series, especially when they reused the animation, of course. And of course, yeah, he's just simple, webbed up, not too shabby there. Vulture is a supervillain. His electromagnetic harness allows him to fly and increases his strength. They went with the younger version of the Vulture, not the old man Adrian Toomes version, so that's probably a good call. I don't want to scare any kids. Help Spider-Man through the maze to capture Vulture, which, no way that kid got that. He had help from his parents. There's a Vulture. He's getting away. He had to fly through that maze. Spider-Man's going after him. There's no way that kid did it by himself. Spider-Man has a special watch. That's not true at all. This coloring book is lying. What, is he contacting the lizard? What, they never had that in the animated series. This is baloney. You're teaching kids the wrong thing. Also, Peter Parker is not red and have green hair and a purple shirt. That's just, and why is he calling the lizard? Why would he call the lizard and not he didn't really call much anybody a spider tracker. There wasn't really anything else. Dr. Octopus is a supervillain. He can lift 10 tons with his four telescoping mechanical arms. Not too shabby right there. That looks pretty cool. Ephraim Zimbalist Jr. doing the voice for him. He was Alfred, Batman the Animated Series. And this looks like it's straight out of the episode where Doc Ock premiered, fighting in his lab. Maybe he's got Fleish Hardy and J. Jonah Jameson tied to a rocket exhaust. I don't know. Whatever. Hobgoblin is a supervillain. He has superhuman strength equal to Spider-Man's. That's not true at all. And I don't know what's going on with his cape right here. He's got like some Spawn action going on. No, he even said to the Green Goblin at one point, Green Goblin threw a desk at him, the Kingpin's desk. And he's like, how did you lift that? Hobgoblin's glider is turbo power, can carry 400 pounds and flies at 90 miles per hour. They use the same designs from the show. Nice to see I always just think the Toybiz purple glider right there. That's actually really cool to see in line art form. More Hobgoblin, you know, and this time he's going up against Spider-Man, throwing some pumpkin bombs. Really nice action scene right here. If I was a kid coloring this, that would have been epic back in the day. Spider-Man narrowly missing a pumpkin bomb. Very cool. Just I love that they put Hobgoblin. More Hobgoblin. You know what I mean? Find all the spiders hidden in this picture. So let's see. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then right in the middle, right there, number 9. So if you didn't get that one, you totally failed. Kingpin is the head of all criminal activity in New York City, which is true. Yeah, that's definitely true. Don't know what's going on with his leg stance right there. I don't even think he has that long of legs to really bend, and he never had a cane. What is this book doing? He never had a cane. He had that Toybiz cane, but he didn't really have a cane. He's destroying, like, he works in like the office or something like that. He's got purple. This kid was all over the place. This is cool though. I'll give him this all the day. They use the designs for the Kingpin's guards as men. We never got toys for them. We got Vault Guardsmen, but not Kingpin's men. We need toys for that. That would be really cool to see. Rhino is a supervillain with superhuman strength and speed. His two horns, all right, can dent a piece of... That's weird. I never would have... You know, he does have two horns. I gotta double check that all this time. He doesn't have two horns. Well, he got like a little horn. Anyways, Rhino is just a joke. Anyways, he just fails. He's the guy that throws himself into a box. What happened first? What happens next? Put the pictures in order by writing 1, 2, 3, and 4 in the correct boxes. The answers are literally right there, so kids don't have to try much. But let's see, webbing up Spidey, Venom, and yeah, you can pretty much put this together. Although I don't understand, Venom just gave up right here. Venom, he got webbed up and now he's down. That's not a thing. The Spider Slayers are unstoppable remote controlled robots. J. Jonah Jameson has built them to capture Spider-Man. No, Osborn built the Spider Slayers with Smythe and King, just Smythe and Osborn. And Kingpin kind of took over later on. But Scorpion's tail packs a powerful punch, his superhuman strength and speed. Yeah, that's mech. That's Mech Gargan. That's cool. I do like they put the nozzle right there. You know, when he sprays the acid. That was a unique kind of thing for the Scorpion in the show. I like seeing that. And then Spider-Man jumping all around, trying to avoid the tail. And he webs him up. He just webs up all the villain. That's a simple fix. Why even fight him? Just get a bunch of web fluid and just web him up. Which two are alike? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So if you can't figure this one out, you need to try harder in life. Those are kind of like Into the Spider-Verse heads, right? Especially the upside down one. Venom is an all alien creature joined with a human named Eddie Brock. Spider-Man's spider sense can't detect him because he has the same powers as Spider-Man. No, he can't detect him because he used Spider-Man's powers against him. He learned and then can neutralize this book. I know what they're doing. It's just simplified, but come on. And then this is actually frightening. Venom just busting through a wall trying to get Spider-Man. The Chameleon, I'm glad they used him. The Chameleon is a master of disguise. His changeable flesh can assume the features of almost any human being, including his enemies. So I definitely dig that. That's really cool to see. He just looks PO'd as heck right there. He's got the image-inducing belt right there. He's going from Spider-Man into the Chameleon the other way around. So he already did something nefarious. Spider tracers are tiny spider-shaped tracking devices that give off signals and help Spider-Man track down villains while he stays out of sight. And yes, those are the designs that are straight from the animated series. That's cool to see. I'm glad that they kept that. He doesn't have a watch. I don't know where that came from. Mysterio, master of illusion, now uses his talents for evil. Looks like Mysterio got like frightened right there, like, you know? Yeah, it's not a bad design. And then he's shooting, I don't know, special effects out of his nipple eyes right there, which never happened in the show. They are just totally making stuff. I mean, they fight at his special effects studios, but this doesn't happen. And then to stop Mysterio, you just web up his eye nipples. Even the monster's like, stop. This book is ridiculous. Yeah. Anyways, draw a little line between each matching pair. So you just pair up the two spider. These are not very hard puzzles for kids. When Dr. Kirk Connors tried to regenerate his missing arm, the experiment backfired and he turned into the Savage Lizard. The Night of the Lizard is still one of my favorite episodes of Spider-Man, the episode, you know, animated series, and really the one that looks like it had the biggest budget to premiere the episode. This is him kind of fighting him in the sewers. That's cool to see. Kind of digging his nails into his arm, and then he webs him up and he's just like, sayonara, I'll see you later. I'm not going to turn you back into Kirk Connors. I'm just going to tell your wife and your kid you died. We'll just that would have been a different episode. Eddie Brock wouldn't have had to eat that newspaper. Kraven the Hunter was one of the world's greatest hunters. He drank a rare jungle elixir that gave him the strength of kinda. In the episode, Mariah Crawford just kind of dumps the serum on his chest. Also, without color here, it looks like he's doesn't have his tights on. He's just wearing a crazy jungle Speedo. So that's hilarious. And then apparently he's just waiting in the park for Spider-Man to eventually go his way. And he's going to throw a giant net. Again, tight colors is important for looking at Kraven. And then he throws a net on him. And Spider-Man's doing that same pose again, like, but it's like a different angle from the beginning. Let me see if I can find it. It's, where is it? The first couple pages. Here it is. So now it's just a different angle from that. It's like multi-camera angle. Look at the picture on the page and the next. Can you find five things? Okay, so it's like a, you know, what's missing? What's changed? Well, the big one, obviously. Well, glad this kid got him. The spider symbol, the chimney, the plane. Like, those are the things that, oh, God. You have all these Spider-Man characters, and you choose the chimney and the plane. Spider-Man overlooking the city, going, I webbed up every villain in the city, we're good. And then half Peter, half Spider-Man face, which never happened in the show. But they did do the McDonald's toy with that, and then now the Marvel Legends one kind of has it. And then you have the amazing Spider-Man. Boom. Just swinging in, and that's traditional clip art. We've seen that image on toys as well. Nothing left, back again, front. That's, I hope you guys enjoyed this. This was fun to kind of go and just nitpick and have some fun. A lot of indiscrepancies with the animated series, but a lot of fun as well. But I'm curious to know, you guys have this coloring book? Did you have it back in the day? Will it be part of your weird Spider-Man the Animated Series collection? Comment below, let me know. Let's talk everything Spider-Man the Animated Series. And I got some more weird stuff coming that deals with Spider-Man the Animated Series, just FYI. So I'm going to leave you guys with that. As always, drink some great coffee, eat some great food, but most importantly, remember, also I got some new Toybiz figures I didn't think I was going to get a hold of, but we're going to take a look at those as well. And when you do, let me know what you found. I'll talk to you guys soon. Adios.